Probably this is one of the most peaceful societies in this part of Norway. I'm quite sure of it.
And I think in general what we're trying to do here is run a society which is as normal as possible, because we want to teach them how to be good neighbors when they're enlisted. It's all about this creating good neighbors.
There are killers, rapists, robbers, drug addicts.
Welcome to the Norwegian prison system, based on the principle of rehabilitation, not revenge.
I want to meet prisoners.
Yeah, you want to meet prisoners?
Yeah.
You're meeting one now.
You're a prisoner dressed like this?
Yes. So this is the house, and in here is the living room. It's a nice, okay view. And this is my room. It's pretty okay.
Yeah, so this is your cell?
Yes.
Did they lock you in at night?
No. I'm the only one that has the key for it, so...
We watch TV, we can play basketball.
Bicycle, running, swimming,
fishing.
Wait a minute, what do you mean swimming? You can swim to the other side?
That is not allowed. From another side you can swim here, but you cannot swim from here to the other side.
Because they call escape.
You're in prison for murder.
Yeah.
You killed somebody.
Yeah.
I can't help but notice that right behind you are a whole bunch of very sharp knives.
Yeah. Yes.
Nobody here is worried about that, or?
No.
Should I be worried about that?
No.
You're not worried about it.
I'm not worried about it.
That is just for Mac food. That is not weapon. And only for that. That is the last one.
I love this.
Yeah.
If I could get one of these to take home, I would have ketchup on everything. That is like the coolest. Look at it, it's still going.
Yeah.
In the weekend, it's four guards at work in another building.
That's it?
Yeah, that's it.
And how many of you are there here?
115.
115?
Yeah.
And four guards?
Yeah.
Wow. Warden, where's the punishment? Where is the punishment?
The main idea is we're just supposed to take away their freedom. That's the only punishment we're actually giving them. They miss their family, they miss their friends.
Right, right.
But I think, and I hope, when you speak to them, they will also feel that we're trying to help them back to the same society.
You know, this is going to be very hard for Americans to see this. This looks very strange to understand why you're doing it, why you do your prison system this way.
I don't understand why you think this is a strange idea. This is an American idea. Your founding fathers put in your constitution, it says no cruel or unusual punishment. You wrote that.
We have to show more love and affection for each other, to take care of each other in another way. This is the way.
Yeah.
And this is the essence of life, you know?
If we showed a little more love and affection and kindness toward each other.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the way, and this is so important. So important.
Yeah.
The U.S. has one of the highest recidivism rates in the world. Nearly 80% of prisoners are rearrested within 5 years. Norway has one of the lowest, at 20%. And that was something I was claiming for the USA. Of course, I was visiting a model prison, a place for inmates who were being rewarded for their good behavior. I said it wasn't fair to show the American public their nicest place. I wanted to see a maximum security facility. And that's where I went. When the prison first opened in 2010, the guards wanted to send a strong message to the new inmates. So they made this orientation video.
There comes a time when we hear the sudden call, when the world must come together as one. There are people dying, and it's time to lend a hand
to live the greatest gift of all.
We can't go on pretending day by day that someone somewhere will soon make a change.
Is that Braille? Is Braille for the blind?
Yeah, for the blind, yes. Yes. It's art. Modern art.
Yeah, modern art throughout the prison here.
We are the world. We are the children.
We are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving.
There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives.
It's true, we'll make a better day, just you and me.
How many fights have you been in?
I have never been in fights, actually.
You don't need a knife to protect yourself with?
No.
No?
We don't need that.
No. Show me your wounds so that now there are times you've been stabbed.
Oh, no, never.
You've never been stabbed?
I've never been stabbed.
How many times have you been beaten up here by other prisoners?
No, never.
How many times have you been raped in the shower?
Never. This is not going to happen because you got your own shower.
Well, here's the bed.
Okay, that's a bed.
Yeah.
TV.
Got the flat screen TV.
Mm-hmm.
You got your shopping, you got your clothes, you got your pen, if you feel hot.
I'm painting, and besides that, I'm studying art class, you know.
You're taking philosophy class.
I'm going to have exam after summer, so I want to work with community problems and things like that, maybe politics later on, so.
That's not a bad idea. Go to prison first, then become a politician. And speaking of politicians, as in Portugal, prisoners in Norway can vote. And in order to get their votes, candidates show up for election debates, televised live from inside the prison.
Hvordan i all verden kan du forsvare det som justisminister?
Jeg kan ikke forsvare det.
I had to keep reminding myself this was a maximum security facility. Here, the inmates have keys too. And this inmate was a murderer. They had Xboxes and a library as nice as any suburban high school library in the US.
Library is the most popular place in the prison.
They even had their own record label and a recording studio.
Ja, jeg er ikke fyr du bør kødde med, for jeg er han som kun bryter deg ned. Ikke legg an på meg, du har gjort det
feil. Music can actually open a lot of the creativity inside of them. And if it's one thing said about the guys here, they are very creative in all sorts of ways.
Kall meg gjerne psykopat, legg meg gjerne for dødsatlet, ikke døm meg for mye.
They've got their own laundry, they've got a pantry, and yes, they've got their own knives, too.
Where are your guns?
We don't need it.
You don't need any guns?
No. We talk to the guys. That's our weapon.
That your weapon is your mouth?
Yeah.
When it comes to do the job, they really do it good, you know,
yeah.
Because
they ask you
officer,
how
they
doing?
Serve you, you know. They're there for you.
The guards.
It's not like in America. They're there for beat the shit out of you.
Crowd, motherfucker, crowd!
Get it, we're here.